A fossil hey from a CFA. What's up, guys? Ash Begale here, owner of Charleston Fossil Adventures and photographer and co-author of A Beachcomber's Guide to Fossils. Today, we are back with our Sharktooth Hunting the Carolinas series right here in the heart of Myrtle Beach to see what incredible fossils we can find. So come along with us and let's see what's out there. Now, the first important thing you need to do when you come out here on the beach is to find the line of shells, aka the shell beds. You can see there's one off to my right here. There's some bigger chunks of shells. They're a couple inches in diameter. That's going to primarily be where you find your larger shark teeth, larger chunks of teeth as well. We also have a line of shells just off in the water that are more of a rice grain to oatmeal flake size and consistency. That's going to be where you find all the smaller teeth that Myrtle Beach is known for. So you're going to pick one of those lines of shell beds. Now, the next thing you have to keep in mind is that in terms of size of teeth, they're not going to be 5 to 6 inch megs just lying all over the beach here in Myrtle. Even in Charleston, we don't get it like that. Mostly the teeth are going to be about 1/2 inch to 1/4 inch in size. Take a look at this thing. It might just look like a rock from this angle, but if we flip it over, we can see some enamel right there and some enamel right there. So a 3.5 to 16 million year old chunk of a megalodon tooth right here in the middle of Myrtle Beach. Second tooth of the day belongs to Ceratolamna. So we just got a tooth that's over 65 million years old. Just scored a little tiny sand tiger shark tooth right here. And believe it or not, it still has one of those extra teeth or cusplets left on it right there. The next important thing to remember is that the shape of the tooth isn't going to be that big broad triangle. As you can see, we've got some here that are more of a three-parted shape, more of a capital T, capital Y, and we do have some smaller triangles mixed in there as well. Now, it pays to inspect every teeny tiny black dot that you see, because right down here we've got two. We have this one right here, and that's a piece of that phosphate rock. It's very amorphous. There's not much pattern or symmetry to it. We don't want that. However, this thing right here, look at that. That is a super tiny reef shark tooth. Something like probably a black tip, white tip tooth in the upper jaw because it's a lot broader. And it did have serration once upon a time. It's very polished and tumbling around in the ocean. But a true fossilized shark tooth there at minimum 10,000 years old. Looks like we've found a really good patch. Lots of good shells in through here. We've already got two other fossils right away. Another crown from a sand tiger shark tooth here. And then not a foot away, right over here, appears to be a section of fish bone. Perhaps one of the most important rules about finding shark teeth on our southeastern beaches, at least, is the fact that they are all going to be super dark black. These teeth are preserved by a sedimentary rock called phosphate. That's what's giving the bones and the teeth their super dark black color. So we've got a black triangle here. It's pretty promising. It's not a shark tooth, but if you're picking up those black triangles, you can actually find some other pretty cool things. This one, based on the bone structure here, I can tell that this is a piece of Ice Age turtle shell from something like a pond turtle or an extinct giant box turtle. That's about 2 to 3 times the size of today's. Pretty cool little find, probably around 100,000 to 2 million years old. So, what time of tide cycle is best to come on the beach when you're looking for shark teeth? Now, typically people will tell you something about like 2 hours before low tide. I generally recommend people to visit the beach around low tide initially so that you can see where the shell beds are located. Are they up high, like they are for us today? Are they right at the waterline at dead low tide? Now, once you pinpoint where that is, you can return to the beach at the appropriate time of tide cycle. What's important to know is that tides aren't the same every single day. They advance by about 45 minutes each day. So this morning, for instance, high tide was at 7 o'clock. So if we wanted to get out here and try and find some shark teeth early in the morning, we would have zero beach to look at. So always check your tide chart and see when is low tide. That way you know when to time your approach on the beach. Wow, it's a surgeon fish skull. Would you look at that? We've got two little foramina right there. Those are the holes where blood vessels and nerves travel through the skull. This would be a fish very similar to Dory from our Finding Nemo series. And a bone in the skull right up behind the eyes. And eyes probably would have gone right about there, head facing towards me. And that beautiful symmetry, we can see each left and right half looks identical. Also important in the search for shark teeth, as well as other types of fossils, is the ability to recognize different patterns, textures, and then symmetry, specifically bilateral symmetry, where the left and the right halves of an object are identical. So with patterning, I've got a piece of turtle shell here. This one has a pattern of a sponge. If you look closely, all of those are the little tiny trabeculae, or the parts of the bone where the bone marrow traveled through the shell. So all of these little pock marks running all across the surface help indicate, hey, this is a bone of organic origin, and we've got something a little more going on here than it just being a rock. So we've actually got a piece of land mammal bone right here from the Ice Age as well. Again, we're looking for that pattern, that spongy pattern on the inside. We have a smooth cortical wall on the outside telling us that this is land mammal bone. Pretty cool. Once you're looking for that color and those patterns and textures, we can see it looks just like a chunk of wood right here, but because it's super dark black, this one is going to be a piece of marine mammal bone, probably something like a whale or dolphin. Here in the southeast, safe to say it's at least 5 million years old. Pretty cool find right here at the pier. So are these teeth washing in from the ocean? Not exactly. The sands that we're standing on here in Myrtle has all been pumped in from offshore. Sure, originally there was some sand naturally occurring, but every few years they do this thing called a beach renourishment project where they're going to pump sand from sandbars offshore, put it on the beach and make the beach bigger so that all of these condos can stay here. Now, when they do that, all of those fossils and rocks and shells come up with the sand. And so with each tide cycle, and you can see it right over here at the base of the pier, you can see a bit of an escarpment or a little cliff where sand is being eroded and pulled away from all of that renourished material. And when it does that, it's uncovering all of the rocks, teeth, fossils, and shells in the process. So what we're seeing out here today has been washed out from the beach, not washed in. So we've been doing a lot of running around the coast today, trying to find some different pockets of gravel up and down Myrtle Beach. We're at a new site now, and the first thing we found right down here, really bizarre pattern. It looked a lot like trash initially, but this is a section of whale or dolphin bone. These holes are caused by boring clams. And no, that's not just a clam that isn't exciting. This is a clam that can drill through rock, and it will drill through fossil bone and shark teeth as well to provide a little shelter while it filter feeds out the opening of the harder material. Pretty neat. Here's something exciting. Not a shark tooth, but still pretty cool. Right here. That looks like a sand dollar, but when we take a look at the inside, we can see there's limestone. So this is a section of a keyhole urchin, or a sand dollar, that is fossilized. So anytime you see something with rock on the inside where it shouldn't be, you know you have yourself a fossil. So as you can see, on either side of me, there's not really a lot of shells on the beach. However, if we take a look in this channel, there's quite a few larger chunks of shells where the water has carried away all of the sand, and we're left seeing essentially the gravel layer of this portion of the beach. So if you ever come across one of these runoff pipes, maybe don't frolic in the water, but you can definitely take a look and see if there are any teeth, any larger teeth and bone fragments hiding in these channels. All right, we got another steinkern here from a snail. This one, because of how flat it is, most likely indicates it's from a carrier snail. Oh, we got a piece of pond turtle shell here from the Ice Age. Wonderful rugose or bumpy surface on the dorsal side. And then once again, there's that spongy bone on the inside. All right, we found something really cool now. This is making the trip worth it. Right down here, the unmistakable curved outline of a mosasaur tooth. Let's see. Oh, it's split right down the middle, giving us a look at the interior of the tooth. But on the outside, we can see these little fluted lines going down the edge. And the easiest way you can identify mosasaur teeth from other marine reptiles like crocodiles and alligators is in the cross section, they're going to be a little bit more like a squished football, whereas our alligators and crocodiles have more of a circular cross section. Beautiful, beautiful tooth right here. Marine reptile, not a true dinosaur. One of the things I love about Myrtle Beach is the fact that we have a Cretaceous deposit really close to the surface. Right down here, yet another tooth from a Cretaceous species. This one, possibly one like Scapanorhynchus, or probably more likely another large Ceratolamna species. It's really cool to see these Cretaceous teeth washing out in the Carolinas, because this deposit, you usually have to travel quite a bit farther from South Carolina going out west to get teeth of this age. Bringing things back a little closer to modern day, we have another Ice Age fossil right here. This one, the section of a plastron, or the lower shell, from an extinct giant box turtle. So again, we have that smooth interior to the shell, smooth exterior. And then right where the flap, the box of the shell, kind of hinges together, we can see this little sutured line here. And then where it broke, that spongy bone on the interior. So another of our Oreo cookies of the fossil world. You know, we always love keeping our eyes out for things that are not triangles on the beach, and this one right down here is no exception. So right off the bat, we see some nice longitudinal banding running down the length of it, and I can pretty much guarantee without picking this up, it is a piece of tusk ivory from a mammoth or a mastodon that lived here in the Ice Age. Let's take a look. Oh yeah, look at those beautiful grooves. So this would have been the outer cementum layer of the ivory tusk. It's sometimes referred to as the quote-unquote ivory bark, because it will kind of pop and peel off the tusk. But again, because this is from the Ice Age, this dates 11,000 to 2.5 million years ago. Awesome. All right, we got another really cool fossil right down here. It's kind of poking out of the cliff here, but there's enough here to tell it's not a rock. If we look, we can see this nice little curved section hooks over a bit there. This is the internal mold of a clamshell. We call this a steinkern. It's a Dutch word for stone within. It's where sediment filled in the shell, probably a clam or an arch, and the shell itself has long since dissolved away, leaving us with the copy of the internal cavity. Now, if you think a find like this is cool, then we encourage you to come on down to Charleston and book an adventure with our team of paleontologists. Each trip is nice and small, up to 6 people. We guarantee you're going to find a lot of really cool fossils. You get to keep everything you find, and we guarantee a good, safe time had by all. Now, that's it for this time out here at Myrtle Beach. We thank you guys for watching, and as always, happy hunting, collect responsibly, and we'll see you next time.